Hey guys, thank you for being here. Welcome to my YouTube channel, 8600 Miles Strong. My name is Bernadette and I'm happy you're here. So today I'm not at home. We decided to drive an hour and a half away. We are here in Santa Cruz. This is a beach, coastal community. Very nice, very lovely, and I want to share with you some of the things that we've been doing. It's still quarantine back here, but the beaches are open from 5 p.m. onwards, so at least you can walk, still doing social distancing, but at least you can see some nature, soak up some sun, and just feel the salty air. It's been pretty nice, and if you know the movie Us, that's a horror movie I think last year, it was filmed in the boardwalk of Santa Cruz, so that's a cool fact to know. Anyways, today I'm gonna talk about speaking English. So one of the most common questions that I get as a Filipina living overseas is, how is your English so good? And that's a compliment. I really appreciate that coming from native speakers. And I always tell them, well, for one, I'm from the Philippines and English is our second language. English has been used for generations and it's the language of instruction as well in our school system. So that's a big factor. If you've been to the Philippines, you will notice that everybody speaks the language or at least understand it to a certain level. If you haven't been to the Philippines, then that would be a nice surprise for you because it's so easy to be a tourist around the Philippines. Everybody will practically understand you. A lot of times, Filipinos are very shy at speaking to foreigners just because, you know, they're afraid to make mistakes and to be laughed at. Unfortunately, that's what happens a lot of times when we make mistakes. People are kind of ridiculing you or, you know, make fun of how you speak it. And I think that's unfair. And that brings me to the topic of my blog today. This is a very short video. We're running to go home before it gets too dark. I just wanted to talk about this very quickly, about what makes good English and how do you achieve it. In my case, as a Filipino living abroad, it's very important for me to be able to communicate well. And English is a universal language. A lot of people speak it. Even when I was in Malaysia, where Bahasa is the main language, English really helped me to communicate practically with everyone. And of course, now that I'm also here in California. So, to answer the question, how did I become good at speaking it? Well, for one, I took communications in college and I've been a communications practitioner for 12 years now. But other than that, I think a lot of my speaking abilities came from the fact that I've been using it and practicing it forever. I remember being a kid and all I wanted really for Christmas gifts are books. I love reading books when I was a kid. Aside from that, what else can you do as a foreigner living overseas or aiming to move overseas to enhance your English speaking abilities? So today I have three very easy, simple, but very effective steps or tips in improving your English. One, if you want to improve your English, you have to speak it every day. You have to practice it as much as you can. Find someone who will have a conversation with you every day. In my case, I grew up in a family that speak both English and Filipino. So from time to time, we throw English words around. So that was very easy for me. But at the same time, I have friends who are also very enthusiastic in honing their capabilities in speaking English. So that has been very easy for me. If you have friends or family members who are good at it, or even if they're also aiming to improve their English, it will really be beneficial for both of you to converse, to talk with each other in English as much as you can. And that means using it around the household. That will really be the first step that will help you. The more you use it, the more you practice, the more you get comfortable speaking it. And again, don't be afraid to make mistakes. Everybody makes mistakes. I'll be totally honest with you. People make mistakes all the time. The only difference is we don't make fun of them here. Unfortunately, that's so common in the Philippines. When you speak not so perfect English, people start ridiculing you or making fun of you or joking about it. And what happens is we end up holding back. We end up being so shy, too shy to actually speak it. And we end up just not using it at all. This happens a lot to my cousins. My husband is from California, born and raised here, but he's part Filipino. Unfortunately, he doesn't know how to speak Tagalog yet, but whenever we go home to visit my family, my cousins will be, you know, a bit hesitant in speaking to him just because he doesn't understand Filipino, so they're forced to speak English all the time. Filipinos are very good at speaking English, and it's really just a matter of confidence and comfort level. So I always tell my cousins, hey, don't worry about it. It doesn't matter if it's not perfect English, just talk to him and he will understand you, and he will be happy to, you know, have that conversation with you. So along with practicing every day, practicing as much as you can, don't be afraid to make mistakes. The more you make mistakes, the more you learn from it. Again, no one starts 100% perfect. I make mistakes all the time. I know people who are from here, who are native speakers, who still make mistakes all the time. And believe me, it's not the end all and be all of everything. So don't be afraid. Just use it as much as you can. Talk, converse with people. If you are already overseas, then use it as much as you can. Use it in your daily conversations, in the groceries, in the gas station, wherever you are. You will actually have a lot of practice doing small talks. That's one thing that I like about living here in California. You can always have that conversation with a stranger. I know it's not a very common practice for Filipinos to do small talk, but it really, you know, brightens up your day sometimes, especially during this time of quarantine. So that's two tips for you already. Practice it as much as you can and don't be afraid to make mistakes. My third tip is read. When I was a kid, what I used to do is to take my books, get a dictionary, and highlight the words that I didn't understand. And I did this as early as I was probably in first or second grade. So that's basically what I've been doing for the past how many years. There was no 24/7 internet access during that time. I'm not that young. So that was old school. And no matter how you do it right now, maybe it's more digitalized. You can put it on your notes on your phone. You can even use some apps for it. It doesn't matter. The fact remains that reading a book will really widen your vocabulary. If you prefer using ebooks now, that's perfectly fine. There's highlight options and even lookup options right now. But if you want to do it old school, then go ahead. Whatever feels right and whatever feels comfortable for you. And aren't we so lucky these days that we have all the apps imaginable that can help us in our everyday lives, speaking English included. So there's a whole bunch of apps that can help you improve your English or even learn it from the ground up. One app that I've used before when I was back in Kuala Lumpur is called Duolingo. So it covers, I think, 20 plus different languages, including English. There's a whole bunch of apps that you can use. There's Quizlet, there's Babbel, but go ahead, feel free to explore what works best for you. And don't be afraid to, you know, just try it out for a few days. If it doesn't work, then find something else that works better for you. So that's about it. That's super easy. Practice it all the time and never be afraid to make mistakes. Read. Just go ahead and read and discover new words, because that will really be very helpful. Plus, reading is so much fun. And lastly, take advantage of all the technologies available. Most of the apps are free or has free trial options. Look for the one that works best for you. Check out Duolingo. This is not a sponsored post, but that's one that I personally was able to use and it helped me a lot. That's really simple, easy steps that can help you improve your English and make you more comfortable speaking it in your new home. I hope you enjoyed this video and I hope you learned a thing or two. And if you have any questions or suggestions, go ahead and send in your comments or send me an email at 8600milestrong@gmail.com. Bye.